everyone, it's Justin again. In the last video, you learned that there are actually two different types of exponential function, growth and decay. You've previously seen what exponential growth functions look like on a graph, so in this video, we're going to learn what exponential decay models look like. They probably don't look how you expect them to. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to graph exponential decay models. To achieve this objective, first, we'll analyze the shape of exponential decay models and how they differ from exponential growth. Then, you'll watch and take notes as I work through a couple examples of how to graph exponential decay. And then finally, you'll have a chance to try graphing an exponential decay function for yourself. You might not expect a huge difference between exponential growth and exponential decay, so let's compare them. Here are two exponential functions, one growing and the other decaying, both by the same amount, 25%. To graph exponential growth, first we plot the initial value as a y-intercept, then multiply it by the growth factor for every unit to the right. The process for decay is essentially the same. We plot that initial value and then multiply by the growth factor. If you were expecting it to zoom downwards while getting steeper, you were mistaken. There are a few factors, no pun intended, to consider here. First, in order for it to go down steeper, it would have to go down into the negative numbers, but you can't get negative numbers from multiplying two positives. The second reason for this shape is that as the values get lower, so does the amount that's decaying each time. As we get to extremely low numbers, the amount of decrease is so small that we can barely even see it. The values will get closer and closer to zero, but they'll never hit or cross it. So we get this model that gets more and more horizontal instead of more vertical. In a way, exponential growth and exponential decay look like opposites of each other. A good way to remember the difference is to think about how an airplane takes off and lands. If a plane is taking off, it has to start by moving along the ground horizontally until it's able to get up in the air and gain altitude up to where it needs to be. In contrast, to land, the plane has to come down towards the ground and then move horizontally with the ground as it tries to touch down. Exponential growth and decay aren't actually as different as they first appear. It just depends on whether the plane is going up or down. Now that we understand what exponential decay models look like, it'll be much easier to graph them. First, we plot that initial value and then multiply by the growth factor for every one unit to the right. The left side is also calculated the same way as with exponential growth. For each unit to the left, divide by the growth factor until you can't go any farther. So what's different about this exponential decay function? The exponent is being divided by 3, meaning it takes 3 units for the growth factor to apply. Remember, in cases like this, you always want to simplify the power so the growth factor is applied every 1 unit. In this case, rather than having the amount every 3 units, we'll graph it using a growth factor of 0.794 every 1 unit. So we plot the initial value and then multiply by 0.794 for each unit on the right. And then divide by 0.794 for each unit on the left. Notice how, after moving 3 units to the right, the value is half of the initial value, which is exactly what the original function said should be happening. And by moving 3 units to the left, the output doubles. Pause the video now and see how you do with graphing this last example. Let's see how you did. First, we plot the initial value and then multiply by 9/10 for every unit to the right. And then we divide by 9/10 for every unit to the left. Now we have that unmistakable model of a plane coming in for a landing. Now that you have a better idea of how exponential decay works, you're ready to apply it to real-world scenarios. In the next video, we're going to take a look at some situations in which amounts decay exponentially over time. See you then!